Divine smile on you, friend. Come to Dragon's Reach to discuss the ongoing hostility. It seems this... Take a look. You know, if you've got the aptitude, you should join the Mage's College in Winterhold.
Divines bless you. I'll be glad to... And of course, now, what would you like to purchase? Very well. Is there anything else you'd like to purchase? I'm sorry. Is there anything else you'd like to purchase? Very well. Is there anything else you'd like to purchase? Enjoy your visit to Dragon's Reach.
What is it that you need?
I must have misheard you. I thought you asked me to help you trap a dragon in my palace. I'm sorry, but I can't do it. We'll just have to keep fighting the dragons as best we can.
What do you want me to let a dragon into the heart of my city, with the threat of war on my doorstep? There must be another way. The risk is too great.
Alduin, the World Eater himself. But how can we fight him? Doesn't his return mean it's the end times? I didn't say anything about giving up. Now what's this nonsense about trapping a dragon in my palace? I want to help you, Dragonborn. And I will. But I need your help first. Ulfric and General Tullius are both just waiting for me to make a wrong move. Do you think they will sit idle while the dragon is slaughtering my men and burning my city? No. I can't risk weakening the city while we are under the threat of enemy attack. I'm sorry. Then I would be glad to help you with your mad dragon-trapping scheme, but getting both sides to agree to a truce will be difficult at this point. The bitterness has gone too deep.
Maybe.
What of the Greybeards? They are respected by all Nords. High Hrothgar is neutral territory. If the Greybeards were willing to host a peace council, then maybe Ulfric and Tullius would have to listen. Aye, Dragonborn. Maybe you can stop the dragons, and this war into the bargain.
No doubt he thought it was the only way to make his point. And also, because he knew he could. Now, if you don't mind, I've got a city to keep.
Alduin? We heard the Dragonwren shout from here. You defeated him?
I feared as much. I thought it was him we saw flying east after your battle. We are not warriors. What is overlooked in the Dragonborn is not permitted to any other followers of the Way of the Voice.
You misunderstand our authority. The Greybeards have never involved themselves in political affairs.
I see. The dragon will lead you to Alduin, but without the Jarl's help. Parthenax has made the decision to help you. This is the road we have to walk. Even the Greybeards must bend to the winds of change, it seems. So be it. Tell Ulfric and General Tullius that the Greybeards wish to speak to them. We will see if they still remember us. Sky, guard you.
Here where you're not wanted. You eat our food, you pollute our city with your stink, and you refuse to help the Stormcloaks.
Hmm. Balgruuf won't give us a straight answer.
He's a true Nord. He'll come around. Only the foolish or the courageous approach a Jarl without summons. Do I know you? Is that so? Yes. You were with us at Helgen. Destined for the chopping block, if I'm not mistaken. A fair point. Well, you've come to the right place then. Speak with Galmar. I'm always looking for able fighters. Seems we're all branded villains these days. So long as your criminal past stays in the past, and you fight for me with honor and integrity, we'll welcome you into our ranks.
Don't be so sure of that.
Speak with Galmar. Besides, it's about time they turned their gaze from the heavens back to our bleeding homeland. What do they want? I have the greatest respect for the Greybeards, of course. And the dragon attacks are a growing plague. But the political situation is still delicate. Not all the Jarls are fully committed to supporting me as High King. I can't afford to appear weak. I can't agree to this unless Tullius himself will be there. Alduin! The world eater of song and legend! If that's true, well, it changes the situation, doesn't it? Even Tullius may be forced to talk sense in the face of such a threat. Yes, I'll give Tullius one more chance to quit Skyrim with his tail between his legs. And what would you have me do?
If he's not with us, he's against us.
He knows that. They all know that.
What is it, then? Arms or armor you need.
I remember you. You were at Helgen. Speak to Legate Rikka. I suspect we could use someone like you. I see. Then there's nothing further to discuss. If you change your mind, speak with the Legate. The Greybeards. What do those old hermits want with me? Why, there's nothing to discuss as long as that traitor Ulfric is in arms against his rightful emperor. They are getting to be a problem, but I wasn't sent to Skyrim to fight dragons. My job is to quell this rebellion, and I intend to do just that, dragons or no dragons. I'll be the judge of that, Besides, by all reports, the Stormcloaks are suffering just as much as we are from these dragon attacks. Has he? I suppose he doesn't want to miss a chance to bluster about the Empire's many crimes. He's probably hoping I'll refuse so he can blame the Empire for being unreasonable. I think I'll have to disappoint him yet again. Yes, fine. I'll come to this Greybeard Council. For all the good it will do.
I'm telling you, Ulfric's planning an attack on Whiterun.
Greybeards have called a peace.
So, you've done it. The men of violence are gathered here, in these halls whose very stones are dedicated to peace. I should not have agreed to host this council. The Greybeards have no business involving ourselves in such matters. Peace? I doubt it. They may put their weapons down for a moment, but only to gather strength for the next bloodletting. They are not yet tired of war. Far from it. You know the ancient Nord word for war? Season unending. And so it has proved. But regrets are pointless. Here we are. Take your seat at the council table, and let us see what wisdom we can find among these warriors of Skyrim.
Gear, is it? You know why we're here. Are you going to let us in or not?
Now that everyone is here, please take your seats so we can begin. I hope that we have all come here in the spirit
of... You insult us by bringing her to this negotiation? Your chief Talos Hunter?
That didn't take long.
Hear, hear.
I have every right to be in this negotiation. I need to ensure that nothing is agreed to here that violates the terms of the White Gold Concordat.
She's part of the Imperial delegation. You can't dictate who I bring to this council.
Please. If we have to negotiate the terms of the negotiation, we will never get anywhere. Perhaps this would be a good time to get the Dragonborn's input on this matter.
By Izmir's beard, the nerve of those Imperial bastards, eh? To think that I would sit down at the same table with that Thalmor bitch. Either she walks or I do. Maybe so, but bringing her here is a deliberate provocation. Tullius needs to know I won't be pushed around. It feels like a mistake to me. But I'll bow to your judgment on this. But she is to observe, nothing more. We are not negotiating with her. Is that clear?
Ulfric, why so hostile? After all, it's not the Thalmor that's burning your farms and killing your sons.
She's supposed to be on our side?
You know exactly. No. Not this time.
Now that that's settled, may we proceed?
I have something to say first.
Here we go.
The only reason I agreed to attend this council was to deal with a dragon menace. There's nothing else to talk about. Unless the Empire is finally ready to renounce its unjust claim to rule over the free people of Skyrim.
I knew he wouldn't be able to resist.
We're here to arrange a temporary truce to allow the Dragonborn here to deal with the dragons, nothing more. I consider even talking to the Empire a generous gesture.
Are you done? Did you just come here to make speeches, or can we get down to business?
Yes. Let's get this over with.
Are we ready to proceed? Jarl Ulfric. General Tullius. This council is unprecedented. We are gathered here at the Dragonborn's request. I ask that you all respect the spirit of High Hrothgar and do your best to begin the process of achieving a lasting peace in Skyrim. Who would like to open the negotiations?
Yes, let's get down to it. We want control of Markarth. That's our price for agreeing to a truce.
So that's why you're here, Ulfric? You dare to insult the Greybeards by using this council to advance your own position?
Jarl Elisif.
General, this is outrageous. You can't be taking this demand seriously. I thought we were here to discuss a truce.
Elisif, I said I'd handle it. Ulfric, you can't seriously expect us to give up Markarth at the negotiating table. You hope to gain in council what you've been unable to take in battle, is that it?
I'm sure Jarl Ulfric does not expect something for nothing.
Yes, that'd be entirely out of character.
What would the Empire want in return?
Wait, General, you don't intend to just hand over Markarth to that traitor?
This is how the Empire repays us for our loyalty?
Enough! First, let's be clear. This council wasn't my idea. I think it's a waste of time. You are a traitor to the Empire, and deserve a traitor's death. But I at least will negotiate in good faith. Since we're all here at your request, I'd like to hear what you think Markarth is worth. In exchange for Markarth, the source of most of Skyrim's silver. Hardly. Riften seems like a better choice to me. Well fortified, easily resupplied from across Lake Honric. Plus all the mead we can drink. Not enough to outweigh the loss of Markarth. With the Reach in enemy hands, our whole position in Solitude would be threatened. Fair enough. I was hoping you could put aside your loyalties for the greater good. But I see you're firmly in Ulfric's camp. Still, Winterhold would allow us to directly threaten the rebel supply lines out of Windhelm. Better than nothing, I suppose. But Ulfric will need to offer a lot more if he wants me to give up Markarth without a fight.
The Dragonborn has spoken, Tullius. Markarth will be ours. Now we'll see if there's anything behind your talk of good faith.
I don't blame you, Dragonborn. You made the best of a bad situation. But I can see now that this is not a negotiation at all. I know you, Ulfric. If I hand over Markarth, you'll be ready with a new demand. You'll never defeat the Empire, and you know it. But you're willing to sacrifice thousands for your own selfish ambition. Soon enough, I'll have you back under the headsman's axe, and this time there won't be any dragon to save you.
As always, the Empire's fine words are worth nothing.
Stop! Are you so blind to our danger that you can't see past your petty disagreements? Here you sit arguing about nothing, while the fate of the land hangs in the balance.
Is he with you, Delphi? If so, I advise you to tell him to watch his tongue.
He is with me. And I advise you both to listen to what he has to say before you do anything rash.
Don't you understand the danger? Don't you understand what the return of the dragons means? Alduin has returned, the World Eater. Even now he devours the souls of your fallen comrades. He grows more powerful with every soldier slain in your pointless war. Can you not put aside your hatred for even one moment in the face of this mortal danger?
A very pretty speech. But what does
That's
it have to do
with... That's enough out of
you.
I don't know about the end of the world, but this dragon situation has gotten out of hand. If this truce will help the Dragonborn here put an end to that menace, we both gain. Remember that, Ulfric. Now, back to the matter at hand. You know as well as I do that we can't hand over Markarth on these terms.
Damn Imperial arrogance.
I'm listening.
We want compensation for the massacre at Carthwaisten.
You slaughtered the very people you claim to be fighting for. True sons of Skyrim would never do such things.
Damned Imperial lies. My men would never stoop to such methods, even in retaliation for
this
your
is our land, Tullius. All the blood spilled in this war is on your head.
You've been even-handed so far. What do you say to our demand? Well said. For once, you'll actually pay for your crimes. I suppose that's the fairest deal we're likely to get.
It seems we may have an agreement. Jarl Ulfric, General Tullius, these are the terms currently on the table. Markarth will be handed over to Ulfric's forces, Jarl Igmund will step down, and Thangvor Silverblood will become the Jarl of Markarth. Ulfric will allow Imperial troops to enter Winterhold. Corrier will replace Kraldar as Jarl. The Stormcloaks will pay appropriate compensation for the massacre at Carthwaisten. You both agree to this?
I shouldn't agree to terms that so blatantly favor the Empire. I have no choice, though, under the circumstances. But once Alduin is defeated, then it will be the Empire's turn. Remember Evgir Unslad. You should be pleased, Elisif. You've done well for yourself as the Empire's pet jarl. But beware, the Empire's loyalty is fickle. They will tire of this war, and then I will be the one dictating terms to you.
I have nothing to say to that murderer. General, you've proven yourself a good friend to Skyrim. I continue to trust that you will do your utmost to safeguard our interests.
Thank you, Jarl Elisif. I appreciate your loyalty. The Empire can live with these terms, yes, for a temporary truce, until the dragon menace is dealt with. After that, Ulfric, there will be a reckoning. Count on it.
Come on, Dalmar. We have a lot of work to do.
Giving up Markarth is a heavy price for this truce, Dragon. I hope it was worth it.
Jarl Balgruuf, I assume you are familiar with the Dragonborn's plan.
Yes, I'm ready to do my part. Just say the word, and my men will help you spring this trap.
But the difficulty remains, how to lure a dragon to Dragon's Reach at all?
Well, that's an excellent question. You haven't overlooked that little detail, have you?
Ah, I believe I can be of help here. I anticipated the problem. While you were arranging this meeting, I was busy in the library of Skyhaven Temple, an unguessed trove of lost lore. But the important thing is that the blades recorded many of the names of dragons they slew. Cross-referencing this with Delphine's map of dragon burial sites, I believe I've identified one of the dragons that Alduin has raised up. Don't you see? The names of dragons are always three words of power, shouts. By calling the dragon with a voice, he will hear you wherever he might be. He's not compelled to, but dragons are prideful by nature and loath to refuse a challenge. Your voice in particular is likely to intrigue this dragon after your victory over Alduin. I think it's very likely that he will be unable to resist investigating your call. Ah, indeed. I'm no master of the voice, like these worthy gentlemen, but it is written here in this scroll. Odaving, winged snow hunter, as I read it.
There's one more thing. We know it. There's one more thing.
I've discovered who the Greybeard's leader really is. All well and good. But did you know that he was Alduin's chief lieutenant in ancient times? Responsible for terrible atrocities. It's true that his crimes are long in the past, but justice does not count the passage of years. The Blades have been hunting him for centuries, but he was protected by the Greybeards and then the Emperors. Justice demands that he die for his crimes. Until he is dead, I'm afraid my oath as a Blade prevents me from offering you aid and comfort. Justice can be harsh, but Partanax was the author of many atrocities during the Dragon War. Crimes great enough to be remembered for thousands of years. True, he turned traitor to Alduin and helped overthrow the Dragon cult, but that does not excuse or expiate his previous deeds. Whether or not he has truly repented or merely acted to save himself, justice demands that he pay with his life.
Haven't you been listening to me? All the old tales agree that he has some means to travel to Sovngarde itself. There, he devours the souls of the heroic dead to feed his power. You must find his portal to Sovngarde before he returns stronger than ever.
That's all.